Good afternoon, friends.
Good afternoon. Still sleeping.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon.
What is this? If I tell you it's a magical lamp and it can fulfill all your wishes, then I'm sure most of you would want to possess it, right? I guarantee you that each one of you will possess it by the end of this seminar if you are listening to me carefully. So let us begin. Professor William James of the prestigious Harvard University once said that even the most successful people in the world use maximum of 10% of their mind power. When I read this statement, a question arose in my mind. Why do that people use only 10% of their mind power? After a lot of research, I realized that the only reason for this was ignorance of mind. Why there is this ignorance? Why? Because there is no university or school in this world which teaches the subject of mind power. Today, we are going to learn that subject. Yes, my friend, I am going to talk about mind power. So let us begin. Let us understand mind. What is mind? Mind is the source and center of energy in our body. It is the place from where the energy flows to different parts of our body and connects with the energies of the universe. If mind is energy, then what is brain? Brain is the physical part of our body which we can touch and feel, which can be operated on and which can be destroyed. Now let us understand this with the help of computer language. That will be more easier. We, all of us, use computers, right? We know the difference between the hardware and software. In the similar manner, if we use the same terminology, then the mind is the software and brain is the hardware. Now when we learn to train for computers, what do we train for? Hardware or software? Mostly it is software, unless we want to repair the computer. In similar way, when we train for mind, we will train for mind as a software, not the brain as a hardware. Now how many minds do we have? How many minds? How many? Five? One? We have two minds. Conscious mind and subconscious mind. Now what is the difference between the two? The conscious mind has 10% power and 90% of the power lies with the subconscious mind. Till date, you were aware about only that 10% of that power and you were using 10% of that 10%, means less than 1%. And today, you all are going to realize that you all have got 90% of the mind power, of this subconscious mind power, which will you all will use to your advantage. Now what time of the day these two minds are working? The conscious mind is working while we are awake, whereas the subconscious mind is working 24 hours of the day. At present, both our minds are working. But once we go to sleep, the conscious mind goes to sleep. But the subconscious mind is still awake and working. What is the relationship between the two? The conscious mind is the boss and the subconscious mind is the servant. What is the job of the boss? Is to demand. And what is the job of the servant? Is to fulfill whatever the boss demands. So he has to supply to it. Then what is the problem? The problem is that this conscious mind, which is the boss, does not know what and how to ask from the subconscious mind. And today, we are going to learn what and how to ask from that subconscious mind so that we will lead a much happier life. Now Now you must have all heard the story of Aladdin and the magical lamp. This is similar to our life story. In this story, there is this boy called Aladdin, and he has this magical lamp. And every time he rubs it, the genie comes out and he says, "Hukum mere aqa," means command my master. And what happens? All the wishes of Aladdin, he commands and they are fulfilled. We can identify this with our life in the sense that the conscious mind is the Aladdin and the subconscious mind is the genie. Now what we have to do? We have got this mind which is a lamp. We need to rub it to awaken the genie, that is the subconscious mind. Today we are going to learn that. And once you learn this trick, you will be able to awaken the subconscious mind and ask from it whatever you want in your life and they will be fulfilled. Now whatever your desire or goals, you set with your conscious mind and you achieve them with the power of your subconscious mind. This conscious mind has limited power, whereas the subconscious mind has unlimited power. Can you imagine? Till date, whatever you have achieved in life is through the power, that limited power, conscious mind. And today, you all are going to be aware of that unlimited power. Imagine what you can achieve in life, whatever you all want. In short, you can achieve anything and everything you want in your life with the power of subconscious mind. Now let us see how this is possible. First of all, you all have to decide what you all exactly want in life. What is the ultimate goal of your life? What is the ultimate goal of our life? People think money is the ultimate goal of our life. Health is the ultimate goal of our life. Power is the ultimate goal of our life. But my friends, remember, these are not our ultimate goals. They are just our interim goals. Then what is the ultimate goal of our life? The ultimate goal of our life is to get happiness. Why do you want money? Because people think that with money, they will get happiness. Why do we exercise and get good body? Because to feel happy. People want to acquire power because they think with power, they will get happiness. So everybody's goal is to get happiness. What do you all feel? How many people are happy in this world? 50, 40, 10? If you ask this question around, you all will find that only 1 to 5% people are happy. And researches show that 95 to 99% people on this face of the earth are living unhappy life. What is the reason? Why people are unhappy? What is the reason? The only reason is that they don't know how and where to get happiness. And from where do you get happiness? From where? There are two places. One, when you achieve all your goals in your life, whatever you have desired from childhood till date, whatever you have achieved, then you feel happy. Now what are these desires from childhood? First is that good studies, education, after that a good degree, after that what you want, a good job, career, business, after that to acquire a good life partner, after that a well settled life, and after that what you all want, betterment of your family, after that to something, achieve something great and to be recognized, and finally a peaceful life. When you achieve all these goals one by one sequentially, then you feel happy, you experience happiness. But not only that, remember that Warren Buffett and Bill Gates, you all know them? They donated 90% of their wealth in charity. What was the reason? Why did they donate 90% of their wealth? Because they wanted to experience real happiness. These richest people in the world, they realized that money could not bring them happiness. When they started donating and making other people happy, that is the time they realize real happiness in their life. Lately, you must have heard the CEO of Facebook, Mark Zuckerberg. You all heard? How much he donated? How much? 99% of his wealth in charity. For what reason? For that same reason. To experience real happiness. So my friends, we get happiness from two places. One is when we realize all our positive goals in succession, sequentially, progressively, and when we make other people also happy. Now next, I've noticed that most of the people are living unbalanced life. There's no balance in their life. What is this balancing? There are four areas in our life, four aspects of our life. If there is imbalance in any one area also, we experience unhappiness. Now what are these four areas? Let us see. Physical, mental, social, and spiritual. Let us analyze these four areas. Physical area. This area is all our goals, physical goals. Career related, finance related, health related, all our goals in this area are our physical goals. The mental goals are whatever you want to learn in your life, those goals are your mental goals. Social goal is about family and community in which you all are brought up. When you make goals for their betterment and upliftment, those are your social goals. Spiritual goals. Spirituality is about being good human being and leaving a legacy behind. Mostly people misinterpret spirituality with religion. Spirituality is a much broader concept. Praying to God is about religion. But doing good work is about spirituality. And this you can do while you are alive and after your death also. For example, y'all have heard about Dhirubhai Ambani? Yes? He worked hard and created the Reliance Industries. That industry helped the nation develop as well as helped millions of people get job and shelter. Even after his death, that industry is still continuing and helping so many people. We have to decide in our life what work we will do that will help the next generation. This should be our ultimate goal of our life. Now that you have decided, you have got a clear picture of your life. What is your ultimate goal? To be happy. For that, what you have to do? Live a balanced life. For that, you have to decide what is your physical goal, social goal, mental goal, and spiritual goals. And once you have decided that, then what is the next step? Next step is to document it. Documentation is very important. Most of the people make their goals and don't document it. And that is the reason they don't get results in their life. Now, documentation means cutting out all your goals, pictures, and putting them on a board, which is called a vision board. Now, what is a vision board? A vision board is the pictorial document of all our main goals, whatever we put. Now, let us see this with an example. We watch the movie Secret. This is a clipping from that movie. This is a real life story of a person who uses the vision board to manifest his goals in life. Let us watch this movie. Idea of what is the vision board. Now this is how you prepare your vision board. You put a picture, your picture there, you put your name and all your dreams. For students, your dream could be your mark sheet, your dream campus or university, your scholarship, your finance for your education, all this could come here. For adults, it could be your dream house, your dream farmhouse, your dream car, your dream holidays. All of them, these pictures, put them up with a time frame. Time frame is important. Below that, you put your time frame. Now, not necessarily that you all have to do it with manually. You all could do it in this digital world with the help of computer. One of Jitendra Arya's student has done so very well with using computer. He has put himself in whatever he desires in his life, then he put himself there. It's a wonderful vision board. You could prepare one like this. I've done one for myself. This is my vision board. I'm writing a book which I wanted to be launched by Dr. Jitendra India in this year. Then my holidays to Far East, dream house, my dream office, dream car, everything is there on my vision board. Now, ideal vision board for a student would be like this. Students, you can take this picture. It could be your dream university, your mark sheet, your award which you want to win, degree, scholarship, finance and education, and below that you could put your time frame within which you want to achieve them. Now this, you all do it with your conscious mind. Now you all have to involve the subconscious mind. How do you do that? Remember that your conscious mind is your outer world, whereas the subconscious mind is your inner world. So there has to be connection between the two. So you have to go inside. You all must have traveled around the world. You all must have traveled, done an outward journey. But if I ask you all a question, that have you all traveled inside, then you all must have never ventured into it. You all go to USA, Canada, Calcutta, Delhi, those are all outward journey. But when we talk about inward journey, that is what we are going to prepare today for traveling within. This is a wonderful method which we call the inner journey called relaxation. Now what is relaxation? In relaxation, we sit in a comfortable position quietly and then close our eyes and focus our mind on various parts of our body. What happens when you do that? Your mind becomes calm and your body becomes light. This is called the alpha state. In alpha state, your conscious mind gets connected with the subconscious mind. At this point, you need to give command and order to your subconscious mind. Mind you, command and order, not request. Command and order to your subconscious mind. And how do you do that? The subconscious mind understands only one language, and the language of pictures. So this process of showing the subconscious mind whatever you want in life so that it will actualize in your real life is called visualization. Now with the help of a movie, this is a classic example. This is a movie called Iqbal. It is a Hindi movie. A clipping we'll watch from this movie. How this hero of this movie, who is dumb, who manifests his goal into reality by visualization. Just check this out. Now your question will be, but what I should visualize? What should you visualize? You should visualize whatever you have pasted on your vision board. All those visions should come into your mind when you're in this state. Now we'll do an exercise, relaxation and visualization exercise. Now in this exercise, we'll go into an alpha state. We'll learn how to go into an alpha state and then start visualization. Now, first of all, you'll have to know what is a relaxation position. Check your mobiles. It should be in a silent mode, not even a vibration mode. Check that they are in silent mode because vibration also can disturb your relaxation. Sit comfortably in your place without any major movement. Relax, your feet should touch the ground. If they are not touching, for the kids, they can hold it and put it on the seat. Sit up straight, upright. And since this journey is inside, you are going to close your eyes and do it. I would recommend that remove your specs and keep it aside. You all will not need specs because you all are going inside. Now when I am giving you all instructions, please off the light. As I give you all instructions, just follow it. Don't open your eyes. When I tell you all close your eyes, just keep them closed. Now take a deep breath, inhale, and then slowly exhale. And while exhaling, close your eyes. Concentrate on your breath. Inhale, exhale. Concentrate on your breath. Inhale, exhale, Concentrate on the movement of your breath. Now loosen up your legs. Let them relax. Let them relax. Loosen up both your hands. Your hands should be on your laps. Loosen them up and let them relax. Relax. Loosen up your back muscles and stomach muscles and let them relax. Relax. Loosen up your shoulder, neck, facial muscles and just relax. Relax. Relax your whole body from the head to the feet. Just relax. Now I'll start a countdown from 10 to 1 and you will get more into relaxation, deeper into relaxation. And at the count of 1, you all will enter into the alpha state. 10, 9, 8. You all are getting more relaxed. 7, 6, 5, more relaxed, 4, 3, 2, 1, you are totally relaxed and now you are in alpha state. In this state, whatever you will visualize will actualize in your life. So start visualizing. Visualize whatever you want to become, you have become in life. Whatever you want to achieve, you have achieved. All your dreams have become reality. Feel it. Celebrate. Bring that gratitude on your face. Bring that smile on your face. Now, I'll count from 1 to 10. And in this process, you all will slowly come out of relaxation and into a normal state. 1, 2, 3. You all are getting out of relaxation and getting into a normal state. 3, 4, 5. 6. Now, when I'll count up to 9 and when I reach 10, you will start rubbing your palms together and put it on your eyes and open it slowly. 7, 8, 9. Now rub your palms together and then place it on your eyes and open your eyes slowly. Good morning, friends. How did you all feel? Right? This was just a demo. This has to be done for 20 to 30 minutes daily. This visualization, whatever your goals and dreams you have to visualize daily. Now, I'm telling you this with experience. I have been practicing this in my life and I have achieved a lot of things. The list is endless. But I can share with you just two because of time restrictions. One is my trip to US and Canada. I had really visualized this and it happened much earlier than what my time period I have put. Then my house in India, in Mumbai, a 3-bedroom flat with a swimming pool in that complex. This was my vision and I got it. And it was a wonderful experience. Now, we have done enough of theory. Now we see practically how this is visualization can control our body. Like what we talk about, subconscious power of our mind, how we can control our body. Do you all want to experience this? Yes? Now I'll do this demo. It is called magnetism demo. Students, you all have heard about, you all have read, studied in science about magnetism. Can you all tell me what is the Rule of magnetism? Opposite attract. Opposite attract. So now my both hands, I will visualize they have become a magnet. Okay. My left hand will be the north pole and right hand will be the south pole. I'll do that, we'll just watch, and then afterwards we'll do the demo. Okay? Now I'm visualizing that my left hand is the north pole and my right hand is the south pole. They are attracting towards each other. They are attracting, they're coming closer to each other, they're getting attracted to each other, they're coming closer to each other, they're getting attracted to each other. They are magnetism power, they have got, they're getting attracted to each other, they're coming closer. Do you all want to experience this? Yes? Then let's try it. Come on. Close your eyes. Keep your hands in front. 6-inch gap. It's important that the gap should be only 6 inches between your hands, not more than 6 inches. Okay? Close your eyes. Close your eyes and just listen to my command. Just close your eyes. Don't open your eyes during this. 6-inch gap. Keep your hands straight. 6-inch gap. Okay. Now visualize that both your hands have become magnet. Your left hand is north pole and the right hand is the south pole. There's magnetism power come in your hand. They are getting attracted to each other. They are coming closer to each other. They are attracting each other. They are coming closer to each other. They are attracting each other. They are coming closer to each other. Visualize that. They are coming more closer, closer, closer. They are coming near. They are coming near to each other. They are coming near to each other. Now open your eyes. How many of you all experienced that? Raise your hand. 90%. Give them a big round of applause. Now you all might be thinking this is natural, maybe south pole, north pole and attraction is there. But then what is opposite of that? What is opposite? Attraction, opposite is repulsion. Okay. So science rule is both same poles repel. So we'll try that out. Okay. I'll do the demo. After that you'll follow it. Okay. Now I'm visualizing both my hands have become north pole. I'm visualizing both my hands have become north pole and the magnetism power has come into my hand. And both the hands are repelling from each other. They're going farther away from each other, further away from each other. They are repelling from each other. They are repelling from each other. They are going away from each other. They are repelling from each other. Away, away, away from each other. Well, you all want to experience it? Close your eyes. Keep your hands in front. 6-inch gap. 6 inches. Close your eyes. Close your eyes. Just follow my instruction. Visualize that your hands have become magnet, both the hands have become north pole and they are repelling from each other. They are repelling from each other. They are going away from each other, further from each other. Away, away, away. They are repelling from each other. Feel the magnetism power in your hand. Visualize that they are going away from each other. Away from each other. Feel that they are going away from each other. Away, away from each other. See that they are going, see the distance is going away. They are going away from each other. Away, away from each other. Now open your eyes. How many of you have experienced it? Raise your hand. 90%. Give yourself a big round of applause. This is the power of subconscious mind on our body. You all experience on your own body. Do you all want to experience on somebody else? Do you all want to see a demo of that? Okay. The next demo which we will do is lifting demo. For this, I want 5 volunteers, preferably boys, students, all boys. Students, this is a simple demo, nothing, no danger involved. So 5 boys, if they can come forward. Come forward, line up there. I want you to sit here. And y'all 4, you two, come here. You know, you two, come here. You all stand in this corner and you all in front, both of you in front. Front here. Okay. Now, you all need to lift him up with your 2 fingers. Okay, how do you all do that? Just get into this position, the finger, and place your finger. You all will place below his leg here and you all will place below his hand here in an armpit. Both of them. And when I count 3 and I tell you all to lift him up, y'all have to lift him up. Okay? Put your fingers in. Y'all have to lift him up. Okay? At a count of 3. Don't lift him up till I don't say 3. Okay? 1, 2, 3. Pick him up. Okay. Leave it. Difficult? Difficult? Okay. Now you want the power from subconscious mind to lift him up. Okay? We'll get the power seen. It was difficult for them to lift it up. Okay. Now place your hands the way it's shown there alternatively keeping a gap between each other. Come on, raise your hand. No laughing, this is serious business. You always see the power of subconscious mind here. Just place it, one above the other, anywhere, but don't touch each other. Now I will give instruction, you will just follow, close your eyes, you also close your eyes, okay? Now visualize that you all have got the power, enough power to lift this person up. Enough power to visualize that, you all are lifting him up. Visualize that, you all are lifting him up with the same manner, with the same mechanism what you all did before. You all are lifting him up easily, visualize that, you all have got even enough power and he's become like a feather. You all can lift him up easily. Visualize that, you all can lift him up easily. Okay, visualize. Now I'll count from 1 to 10 and you all will visualize. That visualization procedure will be on. 1, 2, 3, 4. Visualize that you all are becoming more powerful. 5, 6, 7, more powerful. 8, 9, 10. Now open your eyes. Open your eyes, remove your hand from there. Get into the position. Same position. Go. Squat little bit. Now at the count of 3, you all have to lift him up. Okay? 1, 2, 3. Thank you, man. Can I have the mic? One of you all, share the experience. How did you feel? Why couldn't you lift him up before it was difficult?
I don't know. It felt like we got more time to, like, you know, feel that, like we got the power of the hands.
You felt that?
Yeah.
And you could lift them up easily. All of you all?
Yes.
Yeah? Let's give them a big round of applause. My friend, yeah, thank you. Thank you, okay, take a seat. This is the power of subconscious mind. This is just a small demo which you all have seen. There are lot of stuff to learn in this. Now, let's summarize the whole thing, what we have learned. How many minds we have?
Two
minds.
Conscious,
subconscious. Now, what is the ultimate goal of our life?
Happiness.
For that, what we have to do?
Balance
life. We have to decide our goal balance. For that, we have to put that?
Vision board.
On a vision board. Document it on a vision board. Then after that, relaxation. After that, conscious and subconscious mind connection. That time, visualize. And it comes into reality. Okay? Clear? Okay. I hope each one of you have found your lamp, your own lamp. I don't have to part with mine. Where's your lamp? Where? Mind. Okay? Your mind is your lamp. Okay. I have a message for students, especially for students. You all are at crossroads of your life. I know that you all have to choose a career now in your life. It's my humble request